In this demonstration, I will show you how to use the DITA Reusable Components view that was introduced in version 19.0 of the Oxygen XML editor. This view is hidden by default, so it can be opened by selecting it from the window Show View menu. It has a tabular structure with columns that display the key names, their descriptions, the href where the keys point to, and the location of the DITA map files where the keys are defined. This view is helpful for DITA documentation projects that utilize a large number of keys. It collects all the keys that are defined in the root map and presents them in a dynamic table where you can easily locate and insert references to them as links or variables. A cool feature that helps you to see where the keys are defined is the ability to group them by definition location. To demonstrate this view, I'm using the Oxygen User's Manual project, which contains hundreds of key definitions. I have a topic opened where I have identified some content that needs to be replaced with keys, and I'm going to show you several different ways to insert them using this view. First off, I've noticed that the name of the product appears at the beginning of the first paragraph. I already have a key defined for it, and I'm using the search filter to look for this particular key. I do not know the exact name of the key, so I will search for the Oxygen XML editor keyword. Notice that the DITA Reusable Components contextual menu includes a Show Definition action that allows you to see where the key is defined. Now I'm going to remove the product name from the topic and I'll replace it with a key reference using the DITA Reusable Components view. To do this, I'll just drag and drop the key into my document. I'll briefly switch to Full Tags with Attributes mode just to show you that Oxygen inserted a phrase element because our product key contains only a description. Next, I've noticed that I have the word perspectives wrapped in a term element. I know that I have a glossary term for this word defined as a key, and in the output I want that term to be a link to that key reference. So, I'm going to select the whole term element, and now I just need to find that specific key in the Reusable Components view. In our documentation project, all keys that were created for glossary terms have the same naming convention. They all begin with gloss entry, so this is the keyword I search for. As you can see, all of our glossary terms are listed and sorted in alphabetical order. By the way, you can change the sorting of any of the columns in this view simply by clicking on the column header. Now I want to show the second method for inserting the key references, so I'll scroll down and locate my perspective glossary term, then double-click the key. I'll briefly switch to Full Tags with Attribute mode just to show you that Oxygen inserted an XRef element. This happened because the gloss entry perspective key has an href attribute defined. There is one more method for using this view to insert key references, which is using actions found in its contextual menu. I have another instance of the word perspective, and I want to replace it with a term element that references the same perspective glossary entry. I'll select the word and remove it. This time I'm going to right-click that key in the Reusable Components view, and notice that there are several options I can choose from. For my purposes, I'll select Insert as Key Ref, and notice that this option presents a submenu that lists all the elements that can be inserted at the current cursor position. I want it inserted in a term element, so I'll scroll to More and select that element. This time, Oxygen inserted the word with the term element containing the key ref attribute. I'll switch again to Full Tags with Attributes mode, just to show you the newly inserted term element. And this concludes our demonstration. Thanks for watching.